Thank you, God. God, you are awesome. We love you. We love you. We love you. We love you. We love you, God. Hallelujah. Well, word time. Amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah. We believe at Bethel Worship Center that worship is when you speak to the Lord, but the word of God is when God speaks back to you. Amen?
Amen.
And so, God, we worship you on today. Hallelujah. Whew. You have your Bibles. I want you to turn with me. And by the way, I want to say thank you all for coming. Amen. And being friends and family day. Amen. If you have your Bibles, I believe I have a word for you. It will be found in the book of Matthew, chapter number 8. Amen. Matthew chapter number 8. Matthew chapter number 8. Amen.
Whew. Glory.
Matthew chapter number 8.
To the Lamb. Glory to the Lamb. Glory to the Lamb. Glory to the Lamb.
Matthew 8. Hallelujah. We love you, God. Matthew number 8. If you have it, just stand for the reading of the word. Amen. If you can't find it, just look up. Amen. Sometimes there's a look up anointing. All you guys do is look up and you can see. Amen. Matthew chapter number 8. Won't be before you long. Amen. It says, and when he was coming down from the mountain, a great multitude followed him. And behold, there came a leper and worshiped him, saying, Lord, if thou wilt, thou canst make me clean. And Jesus put forth his hands and touched him, saying, I will. Be thou clean. And immediately the leprous was cleansed. And Jesus said unto him, see that thou tell no man, but go thy way and show thyself to the priest and offer the gift that Moses commanded for the testimony unto them. And when Jesus was entered into Capernaum, they came to him with a centurion, beseeching him. I want to pray, but I want to talk to you for just a second about the touch. Amen. Father God, we thank you, God. We lift you up. We magnify your name, God, because we understand clearly that there is none like you. God, we searched all over, God, and there's none like you, God, not in heaven or in earth, God, because you are the answering God. You are a God who speaks, God. You are a God who moves. You are a God who looks and you see, God, and you're a God who touches. And so we thank you, God, for your word, God. We bless you. In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen.
Amen. You can be seated. You can be seated. I want to talk to you for a second about the touch, amen? We've been talking, and the Lord told me a while back to start dealing with different principles of the kingdom. And the Lord told me to only touch five things. He told me to only talk about five things, and I'll be telling you what they are in just a second. He told me to talk about his presence. People don't talk about his presence that much anymore. He told me to talk about his preeminence, meaning the Lord is preeminent. He's the final authority on everything, and his word is the final authority on everything. He told me to talk about his power. He told me to talk about his purpose. And he told me to talk about his kingdom principles. And the Lord said that if you would talk about those five things, then you would begin to see healing in different areas. And he began to explain it to me. And by the way, we haven't even got off of purpose, off his presence yet. And here's the reason why, because the presence of the Lord is so powerful that there is nothing on the face of this earth more powerful than God's presence and God's word. The presence of the Lord is the Bible says that his presence, at the mere sight of his presence, God's presence is so powerful that anytime you get close to him, something changes. The Bible says demons tremble in his presence. The Bible says that mountains melt in his presence. It talks about his presence because now, there's two types of presence. We're talking about, there's the weighted presence of the Lord, which is the manifest presence, and there's the general presence of the Lord, or the omnipresence of the Lord. God is everywhere. The writer said, where can I go that I can get away from you? He said, no matter where I go, I'm near you, God. No matter where I go, you're near me. Now, sometimes we can be in a situation where we are near his presence, but can't feel his presence. And that's more to do with us than anything else. But I came to tell you that the writer said, listen, God is Jehovah Shammah. He never comes nor goes. He's Shammah. He just simply is there, every place at all times. And we can find God when we search him with our whole heart. Amen? Now, God's weighted presence is when God sees a thing and God comes and he sits on that thing and his presence is made manifest with us. They said, they call Jesus with us God, Jehovah. And so I need you to catch something as I begin to explain. The Bible says that Jesus had finished doing ministry, and he was up on the mountaintop, and Jesus decided to come down. It's an interesting thing that God never does anything without a purpose. The Bible says he was up high, and he decided to come down low. And I believe that when he did that, that signified that there was a destiny that God had that he wanted to deal with his people. He was up high. He looked low, and he decided to come down and meet with somebody. And I came to tell you that there was a man in the story who he had a destiny to meet with God. Last week, we talked about a man who had, he was on a cart and he was sick. And the Bible said that he was so sick that he couldn't carry himself, and his friends carried them to see the Lord. And when they couldn't get close to the Lord, because that presence was so valuable, they tore the roof off the building and lowered their friends in. The reason why I had to repeat that is because I need to let you know that those of you in this room, you need to find a friend who got rip off the roof faith for you. Yeah. Somebody who's willing to bring you into the presence of God so that you can get healing. Somebody who's willing to, even if they have to tear the roof off of a thing, somebody needs some friends who are willing to love you no matter what you're going through and say, look, you don't have that problem. I know that's what they're saying, but the only problem that you have is that you don't know Jesus enough. Come, let me show you the man who can heal everything. And so Jesus was walking up the mountain, and a great multitude followed him. And the Bible says it's interesting that he's in the presence of many, but there's something about the faith of one that caught his attention. Jesus is coming down up the mountain. The Bible says immediately they met him a man, and the man had leprosy. And I need to explain to you just how bad this man was. Because by the time he got to Jesus, the Bible said that his situation became so bad that he fell down and worshiped at his feet. What is it about your situation? Some of you may have been going through some things, and that situation was designed to do one thing and one thing alone, to bring you to the feet of Jesus. Well, this man had leprosy, and the Bible described leprosy as a skin disease, a skin and nervous system disorder. And the Bible doesn't tell you how he got it, but let me tell you how likely it was for him that he got it. In order to get leprosy, you must do one of two things. You have to touch something that has leprosy on it, or you touch somebody that has leprosy. Leprosy is a disease of touch. And what happens with leprosy, and I got to get a little gross for a minute, so I need you to pray for me. What happens with leprosy is, when you get leprosy, what happens is it all starts as just a small touch or a small blemish on your skin. And if you're not careful, not treated correctly, then what winds up happening was that thing that was just a minor spot begins to grow. How many of you in this room have had issues, and that one issue may have seemed small at the moment, but when it allowed to go on long, it began to grow and it began to fester, and that leprosy, it turned from being just a minor spot to a sore. And when not allowed to grow, that leprosy begins to grow, and that leprosy begins to infect other things. And sometimes people, because it's itching, and they got an itch that needs to be scratched. Be careful, by the way, where you get your itches scratched. They had an itch that needed to be scratched, and what they did was they began to scratch it. And when you begin to scratch it, the problem with trying to heal your own self is that sometimes when you try, you begin to spread it in other places. Are y'all hearing what I'm saying? And it all started because of the touch. And so the leprosy began to spread, and as the leprosy began to spread, the leprosy went on and on throughout the person's body, and areas that initially weren't affected were now affected. How many of you have had one issue, and because that issue wasn't dealt with correctly, it spread to other areas? And now that issue caused another issue. In the military, I'll let you know I've been paying attention, Mr. Mack. In the military, they say that some issues are secondary to other issues. Amen? In other words, I have an issue that caused me pain, and because it wasn't dealt with correctly, that issue began to affect other areas. And so he was hurting, all because of a touch. There were some people in this room who have been touched wrong. And because of that wrong touch, it's been affecting other areas of your life. Amen? Amen. Got your heart broken by one man. Now you're trying to ruin every man you see. I told you I'd meddle sometimes. Got your heart broken by one man. So now everybody, where you going? And brothers, we have the same issue too. Sometimes when you have issues, you know what I'm saying? That one issue affects other areas of your life. Such is the case with leprosy, because what happened with leprosy is, gone untreated, it began to affect the way you feel things. Y'all know what I'm talking about? Where you suddenly, all of a sudden, become emotionally retarded. You can't, sometimes when we haven't got our issues healed, it's not just that we don't touch or we can't feel, it's just that sometimes when we touch things too hard. Like, y'all understand what I'm saying? We touch things too hard. And because we touch things hard, then injuries begin to occur in other areas. I call those self-inflicted wounds. How many of us have struggled in our lives because of one or two issues? They begin to affect every single issue in our lives. Every single issue in our lives. And it doesn't matter whether it's molestation or any other thing, but because you went through something, anytime you go through something, if you don't go through it correctly and get healed on the other side, then what happens is it begins to take over every area in your life. How is it that one thing can be tied to another Why you want to fight? Because somebody want to start something. That's why I got my fist balled up all the time. In a perpetual state of disarray. And here's the problem that I have, is that this man had gotten so sick by this time, because he is one of the problems with leprosy. Here's one of the problems with leprosy. You may look good on the outside, but see, the problem is once that thing begins to get infected with so much, it begins to seep on the inside. And now your nerves are affected. And like I said, you can't feel, but the problem is, remember I told you, he spread it because he was trying to heal himself. But after a while, limbs begin to fall off. And here's the problem. And so what he did was he sought to heal himself. And a lot of times what religion does is we cover up the thing that's hurting us instead of healing. See, the difference between religion and relationships, you notice I've been on that a lot, is that religion tries to cover up the areas that's been harming you. And so what happens is we come to church, or we don't go to church, and we go to the club, or we do whatever, and we attempt to cover up ourselves. Self-medicate is the word. Begin to wrap that around your palm real quick. Begin to self-medicate, as it were. But here's the problem with this thing. You see, the problem is, see, here's the problem. The problem is we put bandages on ourselves, thinking that it's going to heal the issue. But if you're not careful, what's on the inside will begin to ooze through the bandage. We cover up our issues as if it's going to make it go away. But once we get, and we see that the issues won't go away, then what happens is it starts to affect other areas, and the next thing you know, you got it all over you. And I don't know if you understand what I'm talking about, but that's how some of us, we look spiritually. We got issues, and because we didn't get healed, and now it's all over our body, and now it's all over our legs, and now it's all over us, and now we're trying to get healing in other areas, and the areas have become infected. And I don't know if you understand what I'm talking about, but some of us have been carrying pain around so long that we think the pain is a part of us. And but here's the thing: I came to tell you that there is a master that can come into your midst, and when Jesus comes into your midst, healing is available to you. And so Jesus came off the mountain and a multitude followed him. I need you to catch how broken this brother was. He was hurt. See, some of us, we use those bandages. Alcohol is our bandage. For some of us, the things that we do, for some of us, we use sex as our bandage. For some of us, we've used everything possible as our bandage, only to find out that those things won't heal us. But Jesus came down from the mountain to have a meeting. And this man heard that Jesus was in town. He took all of it. See, here's the thing. He took all of his pain, and he took all of his issues, and he came to Jesus. And I believe by the time he got to Jesus, he was so desperate for his healing. Keep in mind, I told you his limbs was falling off and everything by this time. And he came to Jesus, and he said, "Master, I need you to catch that." He fell to his knees, and he worshiped. You know how much hard it is for a leper to fall to his knees? I just told you that man was injured. And he said, "Master," he worshiped him. He said, "Lord," that means you are the owner of everything. When you say Lord, that means you own everything. And he called him Lord with a big L. He says, "You can heal me if you will." In other words, he was speaking to him about his power. He said, "Look, I know you can heal me if you want to. I need you to catch something." Jesus said, "I will. Be clean." Now, I got a problem with that because I just told you that the man had leprosy. And Jesus touched the leper. I need you to catch that real clear, because when Jesus touched the leper, technically he broke the law. Because in the Bible times, remember I told you that religious folk, whenever they couldn't heal something or whenever they couldn't deal with an issue, they put it away so it wouldn't be seen in the middle.
Because there's some people who would rather appear to be right than to actually be right. There are some people who would rather appear to be clean than to actually be clean. There are some people who would rather appear to be healed than to actually be healed. And don't think you can't be seen with your issues oozing. They see you. We just love each other. And then as soon as somebody walks by, I can't stand you. I'll punch you dead in your mouth. We see you. The doctor should know. We see you. We do. And it showed, I'm telling you, it showed just like some of the stains in this thing. I don't know those parts. But listen, but we see it. Jesus stepped down up the mountain. He says, I'm willing. Be clean. The reason why I made that statement about putting stuff away is because of this. Religious people have a notorious habit of putting stuff away that they don't want to deal with. My relationship with God says, come closer. Let me see about this thing. Let me heal you. And the Bible says this, that Jesus chose to touch this man, even though it was illegal to touch him. Jesus understood that for you. Listen, here's the thing that they did with the people with leprosy. When the person with leprosy first found out that they had leprosy, they went to see a priest. They went to see a doctor. The doctors and the priest looked at him. And then what they did was they pronounced them unclean. And what they did was they put them on the outside of the camp. And these people lived. And the problem with living on the outside of the camp is that you don't get the same food that everybody else gets. You get what's left over if there is anything left over. The problem with living on the outside of the camp is that you don't get the love that everybody else got. And it is illegal to touch a leper. So from the moment he was pronounced with leprosy, nobody touched him. Can you imagine going through your life after having been touched wrong and now nobody's being able to touch you the same way again? Can you imagine after going through life after having a negative touch, now nobody touches you? This man was deprived of love by this point. This man was ostracized by his family, by his friends, by his loved ones, by those he had blessed, and now he's on the outside of the camp looking in, but Jesus is coming down off the mountaintop. And the thing is, while Jesus is on his way somewhere else, there was something about this man's faith that grabbed his attention. And he said, Master, can you see him now? He says, Master, after having gone through all that hurt, can you see you? I mean, can you see him now? He says, Master, you can heal me if you want. And Jesus says, I'm willing. Be clean. Jesus chose to honor him with his touch. He had been dishonored. I don't know how many of you feel like you've been walking around and you don't feel the honor that you used to feel. But Jesus chose to honor him with his touch. I came to tell you, there is a touch from God. Hear me when I say this. There is a touch from God that can take away everything that's been going on with you. There is a touch from the Master, a healing touch from God, that when you get it, it's like nothing else you can ever possibly get. There is a touch from God that when you see it, that when you get it, you can walk away from everything that's ever bothered you. There is a touch from the King of Kings. But do you want it enough to worship? Do you want it enough to worship and get his attention? He says, I'm willing. Be clean. I'm willing to touch you. I'm willing to make you whole. I'm willing to love on you. I know you were touched wrong. I know some things went your way. I know some of you were never touched. Some of you were touched wrong. I know that you've gone through hardship. I know that you've gone through hard times. And whatever it is that brought you to your knees. But since you're before me, you might as well worship. I'm willing to heal you. I'm willing to make you whole. I'm willing to bless you in areas where you weren't blessed before. I'm willing to do exceedingly abundantly above all that you can ask or think. But I require worship. I require for you to give me that thing as a gift. I require for you to, if you want to bless God, give him your sickness. Say, God, I give it to you. Give him your pain. Give him your mistrust. Give him your hurt. Give him that thing that's affecting you in your private areas. I'm not coming just for the person that you pretend to be. I'm talking about the leprosy that's up under that stuff. God says, give it to me. I want you to stand. He says, I'm willing to touch you. See, that man was that way for a season. But I need you to understand that when you attach yourself to Jesus, everything attached to you wins. When you attach yourself to the Master, when you attach yourself to healing, when you attach yourself to being clean, everything that's attached to you begins to win. Everything attached to you begins to become healed. But you got to get to the Master. If there's an area in your life where you need prayer, if there's an area of hurt in your life, I want you to come to the altar. I'm gonna make it short. I'm gonna make it sweet. If there's a thing, sometimes you grab things and they're grabbing you. But if there's an area where you need